Hi guys, welcome back to GEISHAGAMING! Okay, so this is another legendary rank match where my spawn is one of the most cursed spawn on this arms factory. Okay, so Nightmare. Some quick tips to Kite Nightmare. He has short hitbox, kinda similar like Geisha. Tight kiting is the key, and in the beginning, you know, like the claw thing is slow to lock on you. The claw has larger hitbox than normal hit though. So what I do is like doing this. But the problem is once you have dropped it, then the claw has been locked. So you need to be careful because if you drop the pallet like immediately, you can get a hit from the claw thing. So be careful with it. As you can see, the symbol of the claw is here. So you know that he still can use the claw thing. Okay, and remember when the crow is on you, I mean like above your head, he can see you with the red highlight just like this. And you also get a small debuff though. Okay, he still tries to get me beside the pallet, and then that's the blink claw though. Not the blink hit, yeah, I mean like I told you, the claw has a bit larger hitbox rather than normal hitbox. So as you can see here, actually on this situation, yeah, I mean I also play hunter. So I know it's supposed to be at least two ciphers have been popped on this situation. I mean like, when I play hunter, the survivor down fast. The cipher is faster, bro. I mean like crazy. If you play dual faction, then you will know what I'm trying to say. To be fair, I am actually more into main survivor since 2018. And I realized about the cipher rush. So I told Blubber, my duo here, to rescue before half, like around 49 or 45%, so we have more time for the rest of the survivor to rush the decoding. Okay, still keep chasing me here. I'm trying to block the way over there and pushing him away with my beef. So as you can see here, this is what we call a clean rescue, which means that Gravekeeper can go for the next rescue again because we are utilizing the Titaner on the first rescue. No one injured, only me. So Gravekeeper can go for the rescue after this, after finishing his cipher. Okay, so I was still utilizing my B, blocking the way. I think this purple claw effect is bugged though on the safe replay. So you can see like the purple effect is still there. Okay, so as you can see here, I actually only play with my duo here, the Gravekeeper, which means that we need to rely on each other, and we know that if Gravekeeper do a perfect clean rescue in the beginning, so Gravekeeper can go for the next rescue. There are only two ciphers left with a lot of progress. We know we can make it, our calculation is right. So Gravekeeper need to go for the rescue. Magician and Barmaid need to rush the decoding progress. Okay, using the shuffle skill, try to buy more time. Okay, hitting the shuffle skill. Okay, wait for a bit. Okay, hitting the chair. Okay, now protecting me until the cipher, the last cipher is prime. On this stage, actually the best way is to help the first victim that being tunneled by the hunter. You know, like what my duo here is doing to protecting me. Okay, so again, when Nightmare is on full presence, the claw lock thing will be faster than before. So Nightmare knew he need to chase the last cipher. It's about to prime. I think Biomed cannot finish it on time. I am priorities because I already sit 2 times, so I need to be healed. Okay, so oh no, get a bling though. Okay, get a bling hit. Okay, so this is not a good situation to be honest, because Barmaid down near the cipher machine and he gotta put Barmaid over there, I mean like that chair. Okay, so just precaution, I mean like because Barmaid suddenly need to sit, I heal Gravekeeper too, as you know, like precaution. Okay, chasing Magician now because he is decoding right in front of the chair. Okay, so well, me and Bulber was telling each other like, okay, you go for the rescue, I will go to the cipher machine. Okay, and you need to go from behind it. I mean like the reason why from behind, because Nightmare will not gonna see me, and it is the best way because Nightmare will gonna try to keep tunneling me back again, and it's gonna be very dangerous. So I already stand by on last cipher. So let's pop the cipher machine. So here's the thing that you guys need to know, yeah. The one that opening the exit gate supposed to be not the one that being tunnel since the beginning. I mean like, don't let the first victim that already sit 2 times opening the gate. It will be very dangerous because what happened if hunter teleport like this, Gatekeeper still has the shuffle skill though. So it's still fine. can you imagine if I'm the one that opening the gate? It's gonna be dangerous. I'm gonna die and fly right away. Okay, so we need to split up. So I don't want to run together with the barmaid. It's very dangerous, especially if you go in the middle map where hunter can see you very clear from far away. Let me tell you, I mean, like, I also play hunter, so I know that you can see survivor from very far away. So if you have sit until two times, please never go running away in the middle map where hunter can see you perfectly fine. So still waiting for the other gate to get open, but I know that the dungeon is on the middle map. So yep, after the hunter teleporting, I can go freely to the dungeon. Okay, so that's the video. I hope you get some insight from this video, like a quick tips to kite nightmare. Okay, so I see you again on my next video. Okay guys, bye bye.